Hello everyone, so today I am going to draw some easy fruits. So let's start. So first of all I will draw a pomegranate. So like this I will make a round. And like this I will make the round. On the lower side. So this is my pomegranate. Now I will draw the next fruit, mango. And on the lower side I will make a curve. Just extend it like this. Join it from the upper side. Now I will just make a outline again. So this is my mango fruit. Now mango fruit is ready. Now I will make apple. So I will draw the apple. For apple I will make little heart shape. Join it from the lower side, this also. So this is apple now. And now I will make papaya, another fruit, papaya. Papaya I will make a little thin on the upper side, and on the lower side I'll make little more broad. Now this is my papaya. And one more fruit I'll make, that is banana. Banana I will make long. So these are my five fruits, and I have completed my drawing. So I have drawn five fruits. And that is pomegranate, mango, apple, pomegranate, mango, apple, papaya and banana. So this my drawing is ready. This you can use as a worksheet, and you can give it after drawing. You can give it to your children in school or at home to your children, and they can color it and they can even learn the name of fruits. So now I will start coloring it. I will use my crayons for this coloring. So now I will color it red. Color it in one direction. So you like this, you can just color it. You can use whatever medium you want, like crayons, oil pastel, pencil color, anything. And even it is very useful for teaching the colors also to children. So you can tell it is red color, so children can have the concept of color also. So I have colored the pomegranate with red color, so even this can have the concept of color and the fruit also. Now I will color mango. We all know mango is yellow in color, so we can teach the concept yellow and the mango. And then again, if the child is in LKG class, they can learn the spelling also, M-A-N-G-O, mango. Then they can write down in the copy and learn it also. So you can use it according to the class. So even that, this worksheet can be used for playgroup also, nursery also, LKG, UKG, all the four classes you can use it, and accordingly you can add some more activities along with it. This is the base worksheet. So now you can see this is yellow color mango, and now the apple, I will color apple, that also I will do with red color. So you can start, and while coloring please tell that they have to color in one direction. Don't change the direction while coloring, then it looks more neat. So like this you can just color it yellow and red, and along with it on the sides you can do little bit of more shading again, second layer, so it can look like a shading also. So now my apple is also ready, and now I will color papaya. Now papaya I will do with yellow color. So in this we can have the concept of two colors. Basically we are taking two main colors, that is yellow and red. So when these are the primary colors, basic colors. So basically whenever you will start the class, you will start the concept of coloring, this worksheet you can give the children, so they don't get confused. So start with the yellow and red. So in this mostly the fruits are yellow and red in color. So papaya is also your yellow color. So now we have done yellow color, and little bit of shading of green also we can give. So it will look more, because papaya also have the shading of green color. Now I will color the banana. Banana is also yellow in color, so I will color it yellow. So now I have colored it yellow, and little bit of shading also we can give with the green color. So now we can see this is a worksheet which you can draw and give it to the children. The children can have the concept of colors, the concept of fruits, and even they can learn the spellings also of fruits. Then give them a copy where they can write down the fruit's name 4-5 times to learn it properly. And one more activity you can add with it, that is a Montessori activity that you can do, that you can show the real fruits to the children. Now for Montessori activity is very important that you should always relate the drawing or whatever you are teaching with the real thing. It is very important. So you can bring some fruits, whatever fruits are you have drawn in the copy, and then one by one you can give to the child and ask them to place it on the drawing, so that they can have the concept of color also, and they can have the concept of the fruit also. So let's start. Okay, Kirti, please keep it on banana. Very good. Now keep it on pomegranate. Okay, Kirti, keep the pomegranate on the pomegranate. Very good. Now keep the mango. Keep the mango on the mango. Keep it on the mango. Very good. Now the apple. Now keep the apple on the drawing of apple. Yes, very good. Now tell the color also. What is the color of apple? And the papaya on the drawing of papaya. Okay, very good. So you can see this is like this. You can teach the real fruits also. So like this the child can learn the real fruits, the concept of real fruits, and that is very important. And after the class you can even make a fruit salad and let the child taste it, so that they can have the taste also, and tell them what is sweet, the sensory and other concept. Many more concept you can add along in this single activity. So I hope you must have enjoyed the activity, and first of all you must have enjoyed the drawing. And then you can use it in your day-to-day activities for children in school or at home. And it is like a game actually, so children will love it. So just draw the drawing, give it to the child, let them color, then bring the real fruits, let them ask them to keep it on the fruits drawing, and so many activities. Let them learn the spellings of the fruit. So there are so many activities you can do. So please subscribe my channel if you have not yet subscribed. एंड प्लीज शेयर इट विद ऑल एवरीवन हु एवर इज इन द फील्ड ऑफ ड्रॉइंग हु वांट्स टू ड्रॉ एंड हु एवर वांट इज इन द फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन. सो I will bring many, many more videos for you, many activities. I always try to draw something and then connect it with the education. So it can be used in both the ways, for drawing also and for education also. So I think you must have enjoyed it. Okay, bye.